I can show you two notes. Here is one note and here is another note. You cannot say that which one is useful and which one is not useful, right? Similarly, money is always needed to us. But if we use this in a wrong way, then it will give us a wrong way. So utilization of money is very important, and in which way we are using it is also very important.
The offense of money laundering is defined under Section 3 of the PMLA, that is Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002, which for ease of understanding can be deconstructed as whosoever, directly or indirectly, attempts to involve or mainly assist or mainly strategy or is actually involved in any process or activity connected with the process of crime, including its concealment, possession, acquisition, or use, and projecting or claiming it as untainted property, shall be guilty of offense of money laundering.
Money laundering. We all know that money laundering, what is this? This is like laundering our clothes and all. But here, if we are laundering money, as these are paper currencies, we cannot launder it, right? But if we have earned this money through any income which you cannot show to the government, or you have obtained this money or the source of income here, that's why whether it is a dirty money or clean money, which is white money. So now we enter into money laundering. Why we should do money laundering? Money laundering we have to do because money laundering is done to eliminate the source of income from which it has been originated.
Comes the integration phase. At this stage, all our
The laundry money will be laundered. Your dress is ready. It just need to iron, and it's ready for you. You can use it. Like at integration stage, the money is laundered, and you can use the money in a normal way. Here I am showing a picture from the Google, and you can see that a person sitting over there is collecting the dirty money. And he is in the placement stage. As I told you earlier itself, in placement stage he is putting the money into the bank. You can think that by putting the money into the bank, how bank is not knowing the money. For your bankers information, I can tell you that the bank transactions, there are our population is very high. Each and every transaction in India cannot be noticed very clearly. So there is a limit, like 10 lakhs. If any person deposits more than 10 lakhs or equal to 10 lakhs in a single day, then it will be called as suspicious transaction. And those transactions will be come under suspicious transaction and will be handed over to the financial intelligence unit. And your account will be under the intelligence. Okay, then next comes the layering stage. As I told you earlier itself, how the money from the bank will be utilized in different ways. He can transfer the money to overseas banks, or can invest those money in anywhere else. He will do multiple transactions until when the real origin of the money is totally not eliminated. Then last stage is integration stage. When we have only 10 rupees in our pocket to eat idli, we will eat in normal hotel. But when we have 1000 rupees in our pocket, we will automatically go for luxury. So whenever these type of money comes to the at the end, is utilized to purchase the luxurious items. It is just a it's my just opinion. Okay, it's not written anywhere that it will be utilized for luxurious items only. It can be utilized in any other activities also. But it's just my opinion over this image. Next one is, as I told you, the sources of income. You can say that if I am not paying the tax, then whether it is a crime or not. Yes, it is a crime, which is called a tax crime. The IT department will come to catch you, and after catching, you will be punished under different acts. Then comes the fraud. If you have done any fraud, got the money from by doing any fraud, that also comes under the illegal money. It is obtained by you in illegal. And embezzlement. You would have heard the word binami. Did you heard the word binami? Binami. Any transaction which will not be in your name. Like if I am the owner of any property and I am taking any bribe or something, I will tell the other person to that asset will be mine, but I will tell them to write the name on other's name. But in reality, that asset will be mine only. That is called the binami, not my name. Or in simple words, or if I tell in Odia, jo nara more accept a money, but more naan matu. Mu avka ko koi kubhi ta naar rati de. But real she word by her no, say accept a more. Ujran, said a koi binami transaction, said a embezzlement under drugs. Tapala drugs, samasa janjur, what is drugs? Drugs is very harmful to health and is illegal. And the money obtained from it is also illegal. Theft. Any money which is obtained by theft comes under the illegal obtained money. Bribery, corruption, we all know that. And the next one is the placement stage. Here the change of currency, as I told you, if you are going to another country, then of course the change of currency will be changed. And change of denomination. Black money or dirty money cannot be kept in 10 rupees notes, right? They convert the denominations to the higher note, like 2000 rupee note or 500 rupee note. Then transportation of cash. Cash can be transported from one place to another place. And last one is cash deposits. As I told you earlier itself, like within 10 lakhs, if you deposit, it will not come under the suspicious transaction. So you are safe over there. Then layering stage, wire transfer, there are lots of ways where you can change the, try to eliminate the origin. And the integration stage, you will purchase fictitious assets, or you can do any other activity also. Next comes the method. How there are lots of methods by which the money laundering can be done, but we took only 6 methods, which are first one is structuring deposits. Structuring deposit means we now only discussed that we will do deposit the bank money into the bank below 10 lakh limit, right? That comes under the structuring deposit, dividing the money and depositing in different accounts so that it will not come under the suspicious account, suspicious transactions. Then comes the shell companies. These companies will appear in only papers. They will be registered, everything will be there. But the thing is that you will not you will purchase the goods, but in reality you will not give money and you will not get goods also. But the transaction has happened only in papers. Those companies are called shell companies. And third party checks are the checks which will be issued by the other person on the name of other persons, but the money will be yours. And then bulk cash smuggling, you might have seen Sivaji the Boss movie. In a truck you will take the money. That is for the bulk cash smuggling. Bulk means heavy, huge amount, and cash means you all know. Smuggling means giving the money to one place to another place, and overseas bank's ground. And then later on giving the money, handling the money to him, he will tell that take this money to another country, there we will distribute the money. He will tell, right? That thing is what he is taking the money to outside India. By overseas banks, he will get deposits. Then last one is investing in legitimate business. Until if I am investing my money in any profit making business, government will ask me from where you are earning the money. But if I am investing knowingly in any loss making company, but I will get the revenue, means whatever amount I have invested, by just 10% will be lost, then return, then rest of the money I will get. But what the government will not notice me. That comes under the investing in legitimate business, means legal business. Then comes the fish sees the bait, not the hook. A person sees the gain, not the danger. A fish always sees the bait. We always lots of persons have greed nature, so they actually see the bait, means profit, not the hook. Open the danger before it. The global initiatives taken by the world will be discussed by my co-presenter Anita Sapa.
Encouraging the lending Gracias. 2:30.
2:30.
Thank you.
the aunt and uncle notified their mother in the obligation on getting company, financial institutions and intermediaries to verify banking file of client, mentioned on record and information in described from the financial intelligence unit India. The act was amended in the year 2005, 2009 and 2010. On 24 November 2017, it is the ruling in favor of citizens. The Supreme Court has set a statute blocking prevention of money laundering act. This met in particularly impossible for a person who more than 3 years in jail to get bail if the public prosecutors oppose it. Objective of prevention of money laundering. The CMLA seek to combat money laundering in India has three main objectives. To prevent and control money laundering, confiscate and seize the property obtained from the laundered money, deal with any other issue connected with money laundering in India.
As I already told you before itself that the fish is the bait, not the danger. Those are the dangers in global level and national level. And now here is a small figure. I will try to make you clear about this. First of all, if any suspicious transaction is done by a person, then the bank will see it is a suspicious transaction. Then it will inform to the RBI, Reserve Bank of India. Then the Reserve Bank of India will have to inform to the FIIND, which is Financial Intelligence Unit of India. It is established by the Financial Action Task Force. In the previous slide, you have seen that that has appointed FIUs in different countries, which will investigate the crimes relating to this. If any suspicious transaction is held today, though single transaction cannot be a reason for catching a big one, right? For doing that, they will further investigate. FIU will further investigate the victim, and it will, without knowing the knowledge of the person, if they will investigate properly, and then after getting some results and after getting a clear clarity or and some evidences, it will go to the Ministry of Finance, which is headed by the Finance Minister. The Ministry of Finance will now decide whether the person should be punished or not. Now, if the Ministry of Finance will think that if the case which has been came to them is valid and it should be further investigated, or actions to be taken very soon, then it will inform to the Enforcement Directorate. The Enforcement Directorate, the Directorate of Enforcement, is the agency which is in India, which works for all the activities of PML. If PMLA crimes have been taken place, then after the investigation process, the Enforcement Directorate has the lots of powers like CBI and other investigating agencies. But overcoming others, Enforcement Directorate has lots of powers more than them. Without any question, Enforcement Directorate can take any person. If he suspects that I am a criminal and I am doing money laundering, then without showing me what I have done, they can take me and arrest me and seize my property and attach my suspect's properties, and they can put me in a remand and further investigate on my other assets. That is the power which the enforcement enforcement director is having. Which the section 40 or 50, I am not exactly able to tell you the proper section. And the 40 or 50 of PMLA Act, it gives the power to the enforcement director to act accordingly. Then comes the adjudicating authority. Adjudicating authority consists of three persons. One from the law or the judiciary, and another one from the administrative department, and another one from the accountancy department. From these three, one will be the chairperson, and they three will now tell whether the person should be criminalized, should be punished or not. And here ends the case. They will punish them or they will leave them. If the victim now thinks that no, I have not done any fault and I need further investigation and further I need to go out, then he can go to the appellate tribunal. The organization structure of FIU India, you can see that there, it is headed by the director and additional directors, three assistant directors, then deputy directors under them. Then assistant directors and section officers and technical assistants will be there in the financial intelligence unit. As I told you earlier itself, this is the agency which will only investigate. It has no powers to catch any criminal or to arrest him. It don't have any powers of that. Here is the performance from 2012 to 2018. Of the enforcement directorate, it has become. I have taken this from the enforcement directorate website itself. It has shown the results from one. You can see the number of cases registered, number of provisional attachment orders issued, and number of POS confirmed, and number of persons arrested. You can see the numbers difference. It will make you laugh. That 1427 cases are registered within 1-7-2005, means the per day from when the act has been enacted. 2002 it has started, but from enforcement has been started from 2005 June. So from then 31st March only 1437 cases have been registered, but 130 have been issued, provisional attachments have been issued for only 131 cases. And when it comes to confirmation, as I told you earlier, it has to go through different stages. Every stage you can see how many are getting cut down. Then when it comes to confirmation, it is 108 and number of persons arrested is only 22. Here also, if the person don't think that he is not a victim, then he can even apply again for bail and he can come out also. Similarly, till date, means till 31st March 2018, 2,504 cases have been registered, out of which 973 cases have been issued or confirmed, provisional attachments have been issued, and
Provisional attachment, sir.
Attached to the property of the property of the common department, but the department is not the physical department. The enforcement director is not the department, the department. Say act under Amjai, who 180 days upon property was seized for a upon each for a party. Sir, enforcement director. Tapore, then comes the number of POS confirmed. As I told you, when it comes to adjudicating authority, enforcement director have to listen to someone, right? Similarly, when it comes to adjudicating authority, they will say no and they will confirm only 769 cases out of 2,504 cases which have been registered. You can see the level which has been decreasing. In the last, you can see that number of persons arrested are only 152. But the amount you can see It is in 4 figure. In crores, 29,468.31 crores of value of assets have been under this scheme. You can see that how important this scheme is, this PMLR Act is, and how much money is involved in this thing. This is the main objective of showing you the performance of directed enforcement directed, because so lots of loopholes are there. How the people can go out and how you can come out of it. But as I told you, dangers are always there. You cannot even suspect that how you are caught. Next. It is the graph. You can see in 2016-17, I didn't look the previous one, 2005 to 2012 list, only because it will show a vary. That's why I took only 1 year's list. In this 2016-17 registers high level of money. We can even say that by doing demonetization they got lots of money in the 2016-17 financial year. Number of cases registered you can see 221 in 2012-13. It is the highest. But when it comes to sorry for this error, it is 209 and that one is 200. Okay. In 2016-17, here also 200 cases have been registered. A study by a Berlin based NGO pegs India as the most corrupt nation in the Asia Pacific region. According to International Monetary Fund, the world pays up to $2 trillion in corruption. $2 trillion. It's not a small amount. It is the 2% of world's GDP. How much important is money laundering? You can see $2 trillion is not a small amount. And why we need to study in detail? I am also not exactly confirmed, and I am also not a clean or having full knowledge about this, because I have studied about this in a very less time. But as far as my knowledge is concerned, I am telling these things because I took this from different articles and all. And if it is replaced 2% of world's GDP, then how much revenue is wasted to the government? Of course, if money laundering comes, then there is no place of government, right? Then the government should have given lots of use those funds. But here it's wasting $2 trillion. So we have to see very clearly about that. And another thing is that out of 10%, 7% have to pay bribery in taking public services. For example, if you are going to the Tahsildar office to apply for an income tax certificate, you have to pay more amount than the amount which should be paid. I am not saying exactly that you have to pay. If you know the process, you may not be. As I told you, only 7% are paying and the rest 3% are not paying. That means they may be knowing a clear route and how to do. Okay. What are the impacts of money laundering? As I told you, the figures, you can say, you can know that how much it can impact on the economy and the world. The potential damage to reputation of financial institutions and market. Financial institutions means bank will get the reputation of the banks will go down because they are getting involved in money laundering, which is of course an illegal activity. It shouldn't be done, but if they are doing that, then the reputation of the banks will go down and the market will also slow down. People will not dare to invest in start investment in banks. Against the democratic institutions of the society. It's not democratic institutions. It's not exactly a government institution or public institution. Democratic institution is the institution where the democracy lies. For example, if a company is having, if you are having a shareholder of 51% and you can take any decision and you can manipulate the decisions of the top level management, right? If any criminal person, by using the money of a criminal activity, if taking the place of the top level management, He can manipulate the decisions. He can manipulate the decisions. destabilizes economy of the country, causing financial crisis. India is going under the financial crisis. We have seen in past also, it destabilizes because the amount of money which should be given to the government, if you are not giving, then how it will implement the policies or any welfare scheme? It's not getting, it's not using those money, and it is not getting that sufficient fund. And we are now taking loans for giving these welfare schemes, right? Then give impetus to criminal activities. If persons are not, if proper infrastructure development is not done and employment is not given to normal people like us students, and we are getting starved, and we are then if anyone will give money to do any wrong activity also, we may opt that if our ethics are not that much stronger, we can opt that, right? For money only and feeding the stomach, lots of people are indulging into the criminal activities. So it boosts the impetus, means boost, it boosts the criminal activities. And policy distortion occurs because of measurement error and misallocation of resources. As the resources are already allocated, the government will face difficulties in taking proper decisions regarding the welfare schemes which should be provided to the people.
Next.
Discourages foreign investors. If money laundering is going on in your country, in decimal stage, then people will the foreign investors will fear to invest in your country. And it is another factor that why ED is not given more powers to directly confirm the cases. Because there is a risk of losing the foreign investor. If a genuine investor is coming to our country and investing the money, and you are arresting him, that he is a money launderer, and you are arresting him and putting him to the jail, then other investors will fear of coming into our country. So that is also there exists the main risk. That's why without proper proof and with total details, they fear to arrest. Totally confirm or putting them into the jail. Then next comes it encourages tax evasion culture. This encourages the tax evasion culture as the people have earned the money from illegal activities, they will not pay the tax, and if they are not paying the tax on illegal activities also, they will not even pay for the normal activities also. By this tax evasion culture will increase day by day. Results in exchange and interest rates volatility. If our Indian rupee will go down, then the exchange rate will automatically fluctuate, and our money and the normal person will suffer more as the inflation will start. And provides opportunity to criminals to hijack the process of privatization, contaminates legal transactions. Here you can ask me that why you are saying that criminals will hijack. If you are having laundered money and you are having dirty money, that means you are a criminal. You may be a good person, you may be doing social work, you may be doing anything, but still if you are having laundered money or black money, then that says you are a criminal. And a criminal can hijack. He may be an engineer, he may be a CEO of any company, he may be a great personality also. But if he is involved in the illegal activities and earning the money, that he is called a criminal only, and he may hijack the process of privatization. And now you can see that India is withdrawing its investments from public sector units in this privatization process. If those important industries will go into the hands of the criminals, then it may give lots of different disadvantages to our normal people or common people. Then comes the increased crime and corruption. Crime will increase automatically. We have seen that if once a person is doing any crime and not getting into the hands of the police, then he will again do the same activity. That's why they are caught up and put into the loss of revenue. and I now need to tell this point that is loss of revenue. How much revenue is getting wasted? You all have seen in figures which have been given by the enforcement directorate itself. Punishment under the PML. Section 4 of PML prescribes the punishment for money laundering as under. Rigorous imprisonment for a term of not less than 3 years. They can put you in jail for 3 years, but not, which may not exceed 7 years or 10 years. 7 years or 10 years is because there is a difference in second paragraph of the punishment list of Prevention of Money Laundering Act. It has stated few crimes. If you come under that crime, then the 10 years for imprisonment will be given and shall also be liable to fine. Here the amount has not given, but prior to the amendment of this act, before 2012, there was a limit on this fine of 5 lakh. But later on, it totally changed and there is no limit. They can fine you up to any amount. A notable feature is that there is no upper limit. As I told you on the fine that may be imposed for an offence under the PML, the obvious intent is for the fine imposed to be commensurate to the nature and extent of offence committed and the money laundered. Now we are coming into the case studies. I am again telling that these are the articles which I have got. I am not exactly sure about what is this, but these are the proofs which I am having. He is the person, Abhishek Verma. He is a victim and he deals with arms. As I told you, the criminal activities, they will be involved in criminal activities. He has been a suspect in propane submarine case, Augusta Westland case, BBI case, helicopter bribery scandal, and Navy War Room leak case. You can here, Navy War Room leakage. How important information that might be. Navy War Room is not a joke. It can kill our country even. So he is a main suspect, and the very important thing is that he is not in jail. The case will be running. The amount you can see is not less than 200 million. And 4 to 5 billion, 5 billion, this 400 to 500 crores Indian military deal. Indian military deal. Military is a very important, plays a very important role. And nowadays, whenever you will on the switch on the TV and put in a news channel, you will see about the news about the Indian military, Indian defense and everything. And you can see in there also if they are purchasing any machinery or anything for the country, for the security of the country, there also these people are getting involved. As I told you, they can hijack the hijacks. Here it is shown. Next slide. Passport landscape. It is a very important landscape. It is the India's most the biggest landscape in our country. The passport, in simple terms, if I say about this case, the 54,000 acres of land has been given to a trust to keep this and give this land to the poor people. They told them to give it to the poor people or to do any trust activities or use this in any good manner. You can see, I could be possibly the biggest land in the whole country till date. The Karnataka Vast Gold Landscape involves the illegal misappropriation of land allocation. For rupees 2000 billion, it is 2 lakh crores, not a small amount, it's 2 lakh crores. The, as I told you, 27,000 of acres of land has been given to the, has been taken by the individuals itself and distributed to their relatives and any of the board members of the past board. The misallocation, you can see how they are misutilizing the power of the misutilizing their own power. As I told you earlier itself, if a person is doing any social work and involving in any trust, he cannot trust the person. Until the money until I am catching you with the proper proof in front of the media, I cannot tell that you are the victim. Okay. Culprit. I cannot tell you that you are a culprit. Okay. Elgis Jam, one of the biggest jam and the money you can see 20,200 billion of money. He took the old stamp papers and washed them with chemicals, okay, and resold them. And after doing that and earning the money, I told you that you can even misutilize the money can do bad things also. He even went to Nashik and to the manufacturing unit of government from RBI rule under RBI Nashik, where is the printing press, where these commissary notes are printed. He even went there also by giving bribery. The person, you can see his face. He purchased the machinery. He printed those
papers. Sometimes he came like to you.
After going in deep to this subject, tears came. Actually, this much of money is invested over here. You can see how criminals are they. They should be shot down in the middle of the road. In my opinion, literally I'm saying, if you go in deeper, if you are laughing, you can laugh more. I allow you to laugh. But the thing is that your money is also included in this money. Don't forget that. Okay, you can laugh more. I allow you. So you can see, he bought the manufacturing printing machine also to and started his business. Then when came out, he is the only person arrested by our Indian government. It is, I can proudly say that he is Indian. But previous year he died. The Colgate camp, here everyone, you can see, great bureaucrats, political leaders, several ministers, ruling party, were involved. So, you can think what was the result in this case of cancer. But the amount you can see, 10.7 lakh crore and 1.6 lakh of difference was there. When they were calculated. Okay, next slide. This case was false. Yeah, even till date, this might be running in any court. I don't know.
Who
is this spectrum scam?
This
is another big issue. He took 1760 crores of money which should be paid to the government. He manipulated that.
It is delicate.
Sir, yes, I am not saying that. These cases are not yet convicted. I already told myself. This is the Others Housing Society stamp in which they are telling that the war widows, means the army officials who have died in the war, their wives should have been bought apartments or house in this apartment, but they didn't got that house. They people actually manipulated and gave those to their own people. Next one. And true. Despite being illegal, money laundering does not lose its popularity. Can you ever think that is? As it for the
Despite being illegal, money laundering does Besides the advancement in technology has further added the cost of money laundering by reducing its chances of detection to minimum level. It can be suggested that online payments should be mandatory for larger amounts. Income tax debt should be minimized, ethics and values should be more emphasized.